He is here in studio. He's going to do a solo set. We got Nick Thorburn. Take it away.
Open up your door for me. Surrounded by my family, acting like I'm gonna die. But they don't really know about my life. They don't really notice me. Only when I'm burning bright, and that's the only light they see. Do 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 off of me. They said, I'm shopping for a coffin, please. I said, everyone get off of me. Thank you. It's a Dana Johnson song. The great. keep going. It's a Melanie song.
Look what they've done to my song. What they've done to my song. Well, it's the only thing that I could do half right, and it's turning out all wrong. Look what they've done to my song. Look what they've done to my brain, Ma. Look what they've done to my brain. Well, they picked it like a chicken bone, and I think I'm half insane. Look what they've done to my song. Wish I could find a good book to live in. Wish I could find a good book. Well, if I could find a real good book, I'd never have to come out and look at what they listen to my song. Thought of you as my mountaintop, thought of you as my peak, thought of you as everything I had but couldn't keep. If I could make the world as pure and strange as what I see, put you in a mirror, I'd put in front of me, I'd put in front of me, linger on.
Thank you. I love my mother. I love my father. I love my sister too. I bought this guitar to pledge my love, to pledge my love to you. Some water. I'm not no red football to be kicked around the garden, no, no. I'm a red Christmas tree ball and I'm fragile. I'm not no animal, though I am to you. I'm not no crocodile like the one in Dublin Zoo, who lived in a cage the length and breadth of his body, with a window which people would look through and throw coins on his back to taunt him. No, he couldn't move even if he wanted to. I'm not no animal in the zoo. I'm not no whipping boy for you. You may not treat me like you do. I'm not no animal in the zoo. My skin is not a football for you. My head is not a football for you. My body's not a football for you. My womb is not a football for you. My heart is not a football for you. I'm not no animal in the zoo. This animal will jump up and eat you. I'm not no animal in the zoo. And I've every intention of leaping up and getting you. La 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 la.
We have in the studio, we just heard a live set from him earlier. We got our friend Nick Thorburn here. Nick, how are you?
I'm good, Tom. How are you?
I'm great. Thank you so much for that. That was beautiful.
Oh, thanks.
Now, what were the little, there were some nods and some Easter eggs and some, some gems.
Yeah, I think of myself as kind of a, you know, like Jordan Peele, when he makes films, he does these Easter eggs.
Sure.
So I like to think of myself as kind of the Jordan Peele
of music.
Of music, yeah. So I try to drop in little nuggets. If you're listening closely, you'll catch it.
Well, I caught a Help the Aged. I caught that.
You know, I practiced that whole, I learned that whole song, but I just thought it might be a little too sleepy because it does get so... I mean, I love that song. I love Pulp. I think we share a love of Pulp.
Yes, we do. And it's exciting news for Pulp heads.
Coming back. We got to go.
Coming back. We're going to go. Hopefully, Pulp tickets are not going to be
like the Bruce Springsteen like the special. Bruce
Yeah.
Dynamic pricing, they call that.
What a fun
cool world.
Element to add to entertainment to make... To just punish you at all times, just in case you didn't feel punished by the world.
I like a constant reminder. I like a constant beat down that I'm not welcome. Yeah. As you said, you quote this song a lot, Midnight Oil, the rich get richer and the
poor get the picture.
Yeah.
Bombs never hit you when you're down so low. Read about it, the hits from Midnight Oil. I think they're coming around. What if they had...
Dynamic pricing. Through Ticketmaster. Look, we let the market set the demand, you know.
It's just like...
$5,000. Yeah, it's insane.
Look, I don't want to say anything, Nick. I don't want to embarrass you in front of people. When you played Zebulon...
I felt bad that it was $20. I was like, this is a lot of money for people.
I paid $37,000 to get into that show.
Well, I knew a guy and I saw you coming. I knew you were good for it.
Yeah. So. I love when dynamic pricing is going to go. Because the other thing about it, it's just like then it swings the other way and people get punished for not having a wild panic about tickets. If people are just like, like, yeah, I'll go see that show. Then suddenly the floor falls out. Like, it's just. Yeah.
Swedish House Mafia just canceled a whole tour because of anemic ticket sales.
Because they were on the wrong end of that, then, I guess, right?
The wrong end of people wanting to go to their show at all, I suppose.
Sure. Yeah. Well,
who knew? I love the Mafia. As
mm-hmm. Yeah. Now, you, first song you slipped in there, Christmas Tree, is one of my favorites by you.
Well, first song was In a Dream It Seemed Real.
Oh, I'm, see, that's,
you might have missed that.
I got caught up in the tech stuff at that point. I couldn't hear that.
And that was also a nod to you.
Because that's one of my favorite, right? That's, look, Asleep and Forgetting, I'm going to say, because that's on that record, right?
Mm-hmm.
I'm remembering correctly.
The first song. Yeah, yeah.
Nick, I'm already starting to lose it here. We're already in bonus.
You're in year, what year are you in of the Best Show Marathon?
I am now in, if we're thinking about this as 8 episodes of the Best Show, I'm
yeah.
22 minutes into episode 2.
Oof.
And it's going to be fine. I got the energy.
Yep.
Because again, like, not unlike a battery, a human body's like a battery.
Mm.
Donald Trump
said it best. Yeah.
It's a battery. I do nothing, so I am fully charged and I'm ready to go. No, so the first song I will hear when I catch back up on it again from.
You listen to all the shows.
Oh, yeah. Well, I'll listen to you and the performances again. I'm not going to go listen to me again.
But you do. You're a student.
And right? I just pace back and forth when I listen to myself. I'm just
you're like Steph Curry watching the film.
Yeah, just reviewing film game. I call all the Best Show staff and on Wednesday morning.
Yeah.
And I'm just like, what was this?
Who's your Steve Kerr? AP Mike?
AP Mike might be he might be like Andre Iguodala. He's as solid as it gets. He delivers. He's versatile.
Yeah.
He brings it. And he always surprises you. That's AP Mike in a nutshell. Yeah. When you saw, did you see the argument that, I like the Draymond Green, one of my least favorite
you love him.
Players,
yeah.
Said something to the effect that, oh, the 2017 Warriors would have blown out the Bulls from the 90s.
Yeah.
And I was, first of all, he said that like a day after he said, we got to stop with these hot takes. Like, he was making this big stand like.
He's addicted.
He's like, hey, might as well face it. He's addicted to hot takes. he had this thing where he was like, the sports media is caught up in just putting these dumb hot takes out there and everybody gets argues about the hot takes. And then a day later, he drops the hottest of hot takes.
Yeah, but all the old heads, as they call, they're always, I sort of relate to the new guys. Just like, get out of here. Yeah, it was, I mean, I know there was the JJ Redick thing saying that they're all plumbers and stuff. Look, it's not that extreme, but it is a different game. And I don't know. I wouldn't want to be the new guy and being told, this is how we used to do it in my day. It's like things change. Like, you got to get with the times, you know?
Absolutely. Absolutely. I get that completely. I do feel like, it's just a balance, though.
It's
all
it is.
It's
a balance.
Because the worst of the old guard are terrible.
Yeah.
Skip Bayless.
Yeah.
These like bums who just like, and I think the problem is that Skip Bayless is so wildly successful that everybody's just like, well, if you want to get rich at this, then you just do what he's doing.
Yeah.
And you just become like a hot take dispenser.
Yeah. We love our hot takes.
Yeah.
And we love when our pundits are wrong because it just drives engagement. It's like it is fuel for Draymond, I think, too. It's like he gets to say something spicy and then it makes everybody want to chime in, and then that fuels the machine, you know?
Yeah. But even if I was to say, to play along with that hot take, I think I think he's wrong.
Yeah.
Though I think if they were going to play the 90s Bulls, if the 90s Bulls were allowed to play the way the 90s Bulls played and basically
check
hand check,
yeah,
elbows,
forget
like
it. these guys would be on the floor.
They'd be on the floor. Or conversely, if you took those 90 Bulls and you put them
they'd be fouling
in the present day, Michael Jordan
would fouled out in the first quarter.
Well, he I think he could adjust defensively, but he would get fouled. And if you look at him sideways, he'd be shooting free throws. Michael Jordan would be scoring 40 a game because he'd be at the line for 12 more free throws than before.
Yeah.
And the other thing, Tony Kukoc would now be a 25-point-a-game player where he was like a soft dude in the 90s. This game was made for him. This version of the NBA is made for a guy like Tony Kukoc would clean. He'd be a superstar.
Right.
He would be like Luka-level scoring, not ball handling, but definitely scoring. Huh. That's my 2 cents. That's my hot take.
I like it. Yeah. Let's get Draymond to call in.
We should just start a show called Hot Takes.
We should. We should.
Well, speaking of starting a show, somebody here has a show called
Critical.
Critical.
Oh, I love it. Yes. Yeah. I got the hat.
Yeah. and it's you and it's David O'Reilly.
It's David O'Reilly.
Our friend.
Our friend, genius friend.
Mm-hmm.
We do a show called Critical. It's on Apple Podcasts. And we do deep dives on we go into the places that people don't want to go. It's really, we go where you don't want to go, you know, and we say the thing, we talk about the things that people aren't willing to talk about, and we go there, and we, it's actually pretty edgy. Speaking of hot takes, it's pretty hot.
So you're doing the thing now.
Kind of doing,
I want to just.
Kind of doing the thing now, yeah.
You can't say this, but I'm going to say it because I can.
Yeah.
The show is so funny because you are basically rubbing the dynamic of so much stuff back in the faces of people. Like it's so funny. People need to just experience it.
Well, it's not supposed to be funny. We really are just exploring all of these new ideas and sort of speak to dynamic pricing where you just really feel it's almost like a, I guess it is kind of like you're sequestered, you know, you're in this room and you have to sort of talk your way out of it. But we really do feel like the best way to get through that situation and get out of that situation and get into a better situation is to just sort of parse the details of it all.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
So people, if you got to check out, you just have to experience Critical.
It's to be experienced, yes. But I think it's helpful. It's helped a lot of people. Mm-hmm. And we currently make 98 cents a month through Anchor FM. So we're looking for more donations because we are. You talk about anemic sales. We have some anemic sales going on with Critical.
So there's no dynamic pricing for Critical.
Not yet.
You're trending closer to Swedish House Mafia than Bruce Springsteen is what you're telling. We need to change that.
Yeah, we're tilting Swedish. We'd like to get New Jersey.
Yeah.
You know?
No Sweden, yes New Jersey.
Yeah.
Now I was just told our next performance is ready to go.
Great.
But I want to say, well, what's going on for the rest of the year for you? What's 2022 looking like for a Nick Thorburn?
Well, maybe scoring some things, trying to get into more of that world.
Mm-hmm.
And got a new record and more critical little things here and there. Yeah. Trying to do more, just more building little, planting little flowers. But
okay.
If you need a topic for the next 22 hours, someone actually on the I think on last week's episode suggested, or you brought it up, I think, but it was things that happen in movies that don't.
Oh, that's perfect. We will do that during this.
Yeah, because I have one, and I've noticed it all. And once you notice it, you can't unnotice it. Anytime you see, I just got to take a.
Yeah.
I can hear my mouth getting dry. Anytime you see a phone in a thing, and there's a text that comes in. It's always, there's no text before it. It's always the first, once you notice this, you'll notice it. Mm-hmm. It's crazy to me that they don't just add fake correspondence.
Sure.
Before. It's always right at the top, you know, like you see like just like they just texted you for the first time, but they're
As if you haven't had like forty conversations with this person.
Yeah, it's like someone's mom is texting, and it's like, what? That's the first time they've texted.
Nick, you're saying this, and you're blowing my mind as you're saying it. I know exactly what you're talking about. You'll notice it now too.
Okay, it drives me nuts.
But. Everybody, topic switch. Topic two on the table. You can still do topic one, but topic two is things that happen in movies that don't happen in real life. It's how it goes. But now, well, first of all, Nick, thank you so much. You're one of my favorites.
I love you, Tom.
I love you so much.
I love everything you do.
It's such a thrill. I'm happy to be here.